Kandakes of Meroe were reigning queens who ruled from the capital Meroe. Consort queens had significant authority and they co-ruled with their husbands. And there were some queens who ruled independently. And according to Professor William Adams, there were at least 10 regent queens who reigned between 260 BCE and 320 CE. And more than six queens who ruled between 60 BCE and 80 CE. They had substantial power, and during their reign, the kingdom expanded and the economy flourished. The list displayed on the screen include some of the names of the queens who ruled Meroe. I will tell you the stories of the most famous queens.
Kandake Chanakidakitu was the first queen to rule independently. In a carving, she is shown wearing a crown with the sun disk decoration, tall feathers, and a royal gown. Her name is carved in a Meroitic inscription found in a ruined temple. Her pyramid at Meroe was one of the largest. Her funeral chapel was remarkably decorated, and the painting in the funeral chapel portrayed the queen as a large-built woman wearing lots of jewelry. And under her reign, Meroe expanded its borders and the economy boomed.
Queen Amani Rinas was one of the most famous queens who ruled Meroe. She was known as the queen who defeated Rome and secured a beneficial agreement with Emperor Augustus Caesar. She was also known to have sent a pack of gold arrows to the Roman ruler in Roman Egypt with a message which says, "Queen Amani Rinas, send you these arrows. If you want peace, they are a symbol of our friendship. And if you want war, you better keep them because you are going to need them." Queen Amani Rinas did not just accompany her army, she actually led the army and fought the enemy from the front line. And in one of these battles, she was blinded in one eye, and that is why the Roman referred to her as the one-eyed queen. The war between Meroe and Roman Egypt lasted for 5 years, from 27 BCE to 22 BCE, during which time Amani Rinas regularly attacked and raided Roman Egypt. In a response, the Roman ruler in Egypt attacked and destroyed Nabta. But that did not intimidate Kandake Amani Rinas. She was out there for revenge. She responded with more attacks. And in one of her raids, she brought back a booty, including several statues, the beheaded statue of Augustus Caesar. She buried the head of Augustus Caesar under the threshold of one of the temples as a sign of disrespect, so people could walk over Augustus' head on their way into the temple, and they could walk over Augustus' head on their way out of the temple. And the famous Meroe Augustus head is now displayed at the British Museum. Queen Amani Rinas is presented in ancient texts as a fearless queen, a very good strategist, and a skilled negotiator. After 5 years of war, the two sides decided to negotiate. So Kandake Amani Rinas sent her envoy to meet Emperor Augustus Caesar in the island of Samos. And in the year 21 BCE or 20 BCE, a peace treaty was concluded. And it was beneficial for Amani Rinas. Amani Rinas got everything she asked for. Augustus accepted to retain all land captured from Meroe, and the Meroites were exempted from paying tribute to Rome. And during peacetime, trade between Rome and Meroe flourished and increased. Queen Amani Rinas was portrayed as a large-built woman holding spears and arrows in one hand and seven Roman prisoners in the other. Kushite women were usually portrayed as warriors holding swords in one hand. Queen Amani Shahito succeeded Queen Amani Rinas. She was a powerful and wealthy queen regent. We know about Queen Amani Shahito from different sources and monuments. Her name was found in Meroitic inscript in Amun Temple in Kawa, from her palace in Wadbanaga, from her pyramid, from Kasri Prim and Naga, and from a Meroitic inscript. Her pyramid was one of the largest pyramids in Meroe. Her funerary chapel was remarkably decorated. She was shown in iconography as a large lady, and she was well known for her huge collections of incredible and exquisite jewelry. Her pyramid was intact until 1834, until it was looted and damaged by the treasure hunter Frelimi. In fact, all of the pyramids in Meroe were intact at that time. But after Muhammad Ali's invasion, all of the pyramids were damaged, some partially, others were completely demolished, but almost all of them lost their tops. Frelimi was an Italian physician who accompanied Muhammad Ali's army when he invaded Sudan in 1821. He demolished and damaged a few pyramids looking for treasure. And he damaged Amani Shahito's pyramid and looted her extraordinary collection of jewels. Then he left Europe and he thought he was going to be rich. But he found it very difficult to sell the jewelry in Europe because of prejudice during the 19th century and early 20th century. Nobody could believe that such skills, such craftsmanship, and such quality could be made in Black Africa. And Europeans thought that Amani Shahito's jewelry was an Egyptian fraud. In 1839, the Royal Pavilion Art Collections purchased a portion of Amani Shahito's jewelry. And in 1842, the German Egyptologist Carl Richard Lepesius traveled to Meroe, and he verified the authenticity of Amani Shahito's jewelry and recommended to Berlin Egyptian Museum to purchase Amani Shahito's jewelry. And under the suggestions of von Bensen, an Egyptologist and a diplomat, the Art Museum of Munich purchased some of Amani Shahito's jewelry. And now Amani Shahito's jewelry is displayed in the Egyptian Museum in Berlin and in the Egyptian Art Museum in Munich. It is clear that women in Kush were treated as equals. Their leadership, power, and authority was unique to Kush. Women in Kush were fearless and courageous. They fought to defend their kingdoms and the well-being of their subjects. So it is not surprising that they continue to be admired and respected in the present. Women in Kush were treated as equals in life and in death. In death, kings and queens were buried side by side in the same cemeteries, and queens' pyramids were similar in size to those of kings and sometimes larger.
I hope you found this video interesting and informative. And if you'd like to know more about the Kingdom of Karma, please click on the other videos in my channel. And if you have any questions on the topics covered or any suggestions, I would love to hear your comments. Finally, if you have enjoyed watching this video, please like it and subscribe to my channel.